This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to show how to find the six trigonometric function values when you're given a point on the terminal side of the angle. So let's start with a fairly simple problem to get the concept of this down, and then we'll go on to a slightly harder one. So you might be given a problem that says something like this. Find the trigonometric functions given the point 3, 4 on the terminal side of the angle. Okay, so to understand the concept, I'm going to draw a simple graph. I'll have an x-axis and a y-axis, and I'll put a point onto that graph that we'll call 3, 4. Now, using that point, I can create a right triangle. I'm going to connect that point with a straight line down to the origin. I'm also going to connect the point with a vertical line down to the x-axis. So this angle that I've created at the origin is an angle we can call theta. We can say that the side opposite to theta has a length of 4, the y value that I was given. So the opposite side has a length of 4. We can say that the adjacent side has a length of 3. That's the x value I was given. And if I want to find the hypotenuse, I can use the Pythagorean theorem. I know that hypotenuse is going to be equal to the square root of the opposite side squared, so that's 4 squared, plus the adjacent side squared, that's 3 squared. This is basically going to be your 3, 4, 5 right triangle. Okay, so 4 squared is 16, and 3 squared is 9. So I've got the square root of 16 plus 9. 16 plus 9 is 25, and the square root of 25 is 5. So now I know that the hypotenuse equals 5. Once I've got the lengths of the two sides and the hypotenuse of a right triangle, I can figure out all the trigonometric function values. So the sine of theta is going to equal the opposite over the hypotenuse, or 4 over 5. The cosine of theta is the adjacent over the hypotenuse, that's 3 over 5. And the tangent of theta is going to be the opposite over the adjacent, or 4 over 3. For the reciprocal functions, I've got the cosecant of theta is the reciprocal of the sine, so that's 5 over 4. The secant, the reciprocal of the cosine, is 5 over 3. And the cotangent is going to be 3 over 4. Okay, so that's the basic concept. Let's do a slightly harder one. This problem says, find the trig functions given the point negative 1, comma, square root of 3 on the terminal side of the angle. So we can draw a quick picture of this if we want to. We're going to have something at negative 1, comma, square root of 3. So that's going to be in the second quadrant. So we know the hypotenuse, we know the two sides that we're looking for. The opposite side is going to be the y value. So the opposite side is the y value, and that's going to be the square root of 3. Don't be scared by the fact that it's a square root. The adjacent side is going to be the x value, or negative 1, and don't be scared by the fact that it's negative. And now we want to find the hypotenuse. Well, once again, to find the hypotenuse, what we're going to do is take the square root of the opposite side squared plus the adjacent side squared. So we want the square root of 3 squared plus negative 1 squared. Well, the square root of 3 squared is just 3, and negative 1 squared is a positive 1. So now I've got the square root of 4, which just equals 2. So the hypotenuse has a length of 2. Okay? So once again, we've got our two sides and hypotenuse, and we can just fill in the values for each of the functions. So the opposite over the hypotenuse is going to be the square root of 3 over 2, the cosine will be the adjacent, negative 1, over the square root of 2, over 2, and the tangent will be the opposite over the adjacent, or the square root of 3 over, it should be negative 1, I'll put the negative sign in the numerator. And then we're just going to take the reciprocals of each of these to get the other three functions. So I'm going to have 2 over the square root of 3, and you might want to convert that into something without a radical sign in the denominator. I'm going to have the secant of theta, that's going to equal 2 over negative 1. I'm just going to make that into negative 2. And then I've got the cotangent of theta, and that's going to equal negative 1 over the square root of 3. And once again, you might want to change this into something without a radical in the denominator. In other words, you might want to multiply the numerator and the denominator by the square root of 3. Actually, let's just do that quickly. So this is going to be negative 1 square root of 3, or just negative square root of 3, over the square root of 3 times the square root of 3 is 3. Okay? So that's the basic concept. I'll probably do another video with some harder examples just so you can get more practice and understand this a little better. Okay, take care. I'll see you soon.